My name's Victor Seaward, and this is my Invites presentation at the Zabludowicz Collection entitled Holy Bark. This exhibition intersects the histories of natural remedies and industrialization, and it also explores the natural slippages between the digital, the natural, and the industrial. The show is comprised of a few objects that are all interconnected in some way. The focal point of the show is a hanging, nest-like, shell-like, quasi-naturalistic form, which is entitled Oracle Nocturne. This is a 3D printed form, and contained within is gelatinous tonic water. There's also a UV light shining down, and this fluoresces the tonic jelly due to the quinine content contained within tonic water. Quinine is a really fascinating molecule which was brought to Europe by the Spanish Jesuits in the 17th century, and it was famed for its anti-malarial properties. And that kind of leads on to a couple of the other objects in the show. There are some chamomile flowers which are also 3D printed, placed upon a stool. The stool relates to the nest in terms of this kind of medicinal undercurrent to the work. The use of chamomile as a medicinal plant is in fact incredibly ancient. The objects towards the other side of the room deal more with ideas of manufacturing the Industrial Revolution. There is a aluminium panel in the show that has Wedgwood-esque motifs running across the border. There's quite a nice conversation between that and the sock on the tire. There was a point in time where socks were reserved only for royalty. They're incredibly difficult to manufacture by hand, and they break really easily. But then all of a sudden, through the Industrial Revolution till we get to present day, they become ultra ubiquitous, throwaway, almost single use. And so there is a link there. On one level, there is a sock and a tire in front of a blue panel, but on another level, there is more going on that might not meet the eye at first. Ultimately, I'm interested in the agency of objects and the way that objects can have an interconnectedness to one another. There are so many different strands in this show, be it empirical, historical, or technological, and that's kind of the conceptual underpinning to everything. I think ultimately I'm interested in human ingenuity and how that manifests in these objects, and that's what I feel compelled to articulate.